Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, dwyersportsbetting.com, on Roku, Dwyer Boxing and Sports News, on iTunes, one word, Dwyer Boxing News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. You know, there was a fight that took place in Canada. It was the John Pascal Belanti fight, and that fight ended in a very controversial manner. Now, for legal reasons, I'm not going to say that anyone did anything untoward, right? I don't want people coming after me legally later saying, hey, you said that I was faking an injury or anything like that. I'm not saying that. But what I am saying is, what's troubling? I'll say I'm troubled by the video. Because what's troubling to me isn't the fact that Belanti goes down. Right? And understand, Pascal, and I have the film of this in my favorites here on YouTube. Pascal has the ref behind him. The ref apparently tells Pascal to stop. Pascal then throws a very short punch. It doesn't even look like it has a lot on it. Belanti gets hit, his head snaps, and then he hits the canvas. Right? Now, I'm not here to argue that short punches can't knock you down. Right? I'm not. But what's disturbing to me is the fact that Belanti stays down. I'm troubled by that. Right? Understand, we've seen a host of fights. Let me name some of them. Paul Williams on the canvas in the Sergio Martinez rematch. Manny Pacquiao on the canvas and unconscious, right? As was Paul Williams. Right at the end of his last fight against Juan Manuel Marquez, right? The fourth fight. Roy Jones on the canvas at the end of his fight against Glenn Johnson. Roy Jones, and let me just say, Roy, if you're on this list more than once, you might want to reconsider what you're doing. Well, anyway, Roy Jones on the canvas against Denis Lebedev. Now, those are fights where the boxer took huge shots. Huge shots. Hit the canvas. And then, after a while of being unconscious, came to and started moving. Right? Were able to leave the ring under their own power. Now, what is it about this situation, Pascal Belanti, that has Belanti staying down? Right? For me, it's not the fact that he hits the canvas, it's the fact that he stays down that concerns me, especially since right before he gets dropped, he actually gets hurt and dropped earlier that round. Right? In other words, Pascal is having success. And then, of course, we get the ending of the fight where Belanti goes down and somehow, unlike Paul Williams, unlike Manny Pacquiao, unlike Roy Jones, he stays down. He has to be taken out of the ring on a stretcher. Right? If you haven't seen this finish, you need to see it. Right? Tell me if you think something's up here. Let's just say, again, for legal reasons, I'm not going to accuse anyone of anything, but let's just say I'm concerned. I'm troubled. Right? I can understand, being surprised by a short punch, even though the punch doesn't look that fast. Right? I have seen slow punches hurt guys before. I understand being surprised, getting stunned, maybe getting hit hard, and getting dropped. But if you can't get up from that, even after coming to, then I really have to ask, what's going on? I mean, were you even in shape to enter the ring. Right? Let's just say in boxing, we've seen guys get up from far worse. Right here, there's no time when Belanti's able to get back on his feet. Right? The fight has been deemed a no contest. Let me say this too. Fighters understand that in some jurisdictions, if a fight is stopped before some arbitrary point, let's say the fourth round or so, the fight will be ruled a no contest, right? If the reason for the stoppage was something outside the rules, right? Not a, you know, legitimate knockdown, but something else, right? Fighters know this. They understand, hey, you know, if this ends really early because of some foul, then this isn't going to go on the books as a loss. Now ask yourself, moments before the ending of the fight, is there anyone here watching this video who feels that Belanti wasn't having big trouble with John Pascal? It looked to me like Pascal was on his way to a win. It looked to me like Pascal had solved Belanti. Right? So, understand. If you're a chess player, if you're a card player, and let's say your opponent's a little bit better than you thought, or catches you with some punches that have you in a little bit of trouble, right? Is there a possibility? I'm not accusing anyone of it here. But is there a possibility that a fighter in that situation might, after being fouled, decide to stay down? Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Thanks for stopping by.